Hey, what's up, hello guys, I'm Karla and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be trying out this really famous Instagram hack that I thought it was perfect for me and my skin type because I have very oily skin. My foundation just likes to move around during the day and it gets streaky and it gets just really bad. So I thought that maybe this hack would be helpful for people like me who just have a really hard time trying to keep their foundation on because of oils. So if you have, you know, skin like me, then I hope this helps. This is a collab with Gigi TV and she's gonna be doing a Sephora haul, so if you wanna check it out, then it's gonna be in the description down below, her channel and her video. So yeah, I hope you guys like the video and let's get started. Hey guys, so I'm starting with a bare face except my eyes because I already did them. I used glitter and my eyebrows, but now I'm starting with a primer because the direction said to use a primer just so your powder sticks to your face and I guess it stays on better and it stays locked in. Right now I'm using the translucent powder by Tarte and the direction said very carefully that you have to use translucent powder. If you don't, that's what's gonna cause the cakiness if you use a foundation powder because that's a lot more heavier and it has coverage while this one has no coverage, it's just to control your oils. And I'm applying this all over the face, and now I'm using my Makeup Forever HD foundation stick all over my face, and I know the direction said to use like a liquid foundation and not to like rub the foundation in, but to be honest, this is the foundation that I would use anyways, and if you're using something, then use what you use every single day. And now I'm blending it in with my beauty blender. I think the beauty blender way is really, really good because it prevents your makeup from caking up, except don't use it on your nose if you have the same problems as me, which is like, you know, caking up and falling away, then use a brush instead because the makeup barely stayed on my nose. So now I'm using my Tarte Shape Tape Concealer underneath my eyes, the bridge of my nose, and my cupid's bow, and a little bit of my forehead just to lighten up, and I wanted to see how this kind of layered on top with the powder and that kind of stuff, and it did pretty well. It looked really smooth, and to be honest, I think it looks better than before. So this really controlled my oils, and it worked really well in between my eyebrows, which that's a big problem place for me. And now I'm using my Better Skin Powder by Maybelline. I wanted to see how it layered, mostly if it was gonna cake up or maybe have some dry patches, even though my skin is not dry. This is how the foundation looks like up close, everything done. I don't have any blush or highlighter or bronzer on, but now I do. This is how it looks. I think it looks really good. So this is how the makeup turned out. I know it's a little bit strong. I kind of went like really heavy-handed with my eyeshadow, and then like I just chose a really dark lipstick today, and then with like the brown sweater, it's just like everything's brown and like orange. But you know what? I like it. If you want a tutorial on how I did this like glitter eyeshadow thing, then just comment down below. I'm gonna be making one anyway, so The following clips are of me testing out this makeup tutorial, and I tested it out for 3 days. Every single day it was a little bit different, but the thing that I noticed the most, well, for me, I have a very, very oily nose and like the makeup doesn't stick. And a thing that I noticed is when I put the makeup with my beauty blender on my nose, it was like, it was completely falling off. It wasn't sticking. So I had to use a brush. I used my Ortiz brush. So just keep that in mind. Like when I was putting the makeup on, it was like completely coming off. So I had to use this brush to put it on because it looked terrible. Without further ado, here are the clips. Hey guys, so I'm on the way to the bus right now, and I just did my makeup. Well, not just like 20 minutes ago, but here's the foundation. And it does look really smooth. The foundation that I used usually like parts up in my nose, but it didn't, so I guess that's nice. But yeah, right now it is like 6:45, 6:50, so I'll keep you guys updated. Hey guys, so I just got home from school. So this is how my foundation looks like. it kind of separated here, but I mean it always does that, like it's not unusual. Separates on the high points of my face and kind of on the bottom here, but again, like I've been wearing this foundation since like 6:55, and right now it's 2:55, so 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, about 8 hours. Yeah, that's how my makeup looks like, and I'm still gonna leave it on until like maybe 5 p.m. so I'll check back in when it's time. You know what, I got too lazy to go outside, but there's good lighting here. As you can see right there. Apart from that, my foundation looks pretty good. After here, I'm gonna go eat some dinner. We're gonna go out, and I'm probably gonna get home late-ish, somewhat late-ish. I don't know, maybe 9 or 10. So I will vlog back when I get home. Hey guys, so sorry for the bad lighting, but I'm in my room and it's like dark outside, so I can't use natural lighting. But it is 8:30, so it's been about 14 hours since I put this foundation on. So for 18 hours, it's holding up pretty well at me. I went to my bathroom and see if there's better lighting. Sure. So this is how it looks like. My nose, there's barely any foundation there anymore. Yeah, I mean, for 14 hours, I think it's done really well. Hey guys, so I just finished doing my makeup, and this is day two, and this is how it looks like. I think it turned out better yesterday, but, you know, whatever. But right now, it is around 6:15, so I will update you guys when I get home from school. Hey guys, so I just got home and this is how my makeup looks like. Right now it's around 3. And yeah. I'm probably gonna leave this on again until 5 and I'll tell you guys how it looks like. Hey guys, so I fell asleep. I was just around the house and I'm really tired. It's around 5:45 and I'm gonna go to sleep because I'm just really tired, so I'm gonna be taking the makeup off and taking my contacts off, which like feel horrible because I slept on them. They feel horrible. But this is how it looks like. But yeah, it kind of like went away here and in my nose. Like you can totally see the texture of my nose. But overall, I really like this hack. To be honest, I think I'm gonna keep doing it. So I don't know, I give it a big thumbs up. So my final thoughts on this makeup hack is that yes, it really does work. To be honest, I think I'm gonna add this into my daily routine because it's really easy. All you have to do is put some powder on your face and you're good to go. To be honest, I thought it wasn't gonna work because again, like makeup with me, it really likes to peel up and like just go away, so this really helped it stay longer. One day I left my foundation on for I think 14 hours, so it was there for a really long time. But yeah, if you want to try it, go ahead and try it, but I wouldn't recommend it for people with dry skin because that would probably be like crazy land. It would probably like give you dry patches or something like that. So yeah, if you have dry skin, don't try it out. Only if you have oily skin. But yeah, I hope you guys like the video. Please give it a big thumbs up. And don't forget to check out Gigi TV's video. It's going to be linked down below. And her channel. So if you want to go and check it out. If you're not subscribed to my channel, then just click that red subscribe button down below. And if you didn't watch my last video, just click on the eye right here. And yeah, I hope you guys like the video. And see you in my next one. Bye.
So dancing in my head, I must be honest, I have a lot of pride, but I'm broken inside.